You're watching The View from the Bay, live.
Okay, check this out. Americans spend an average of 1.5 hours a day checking and sending email, and up to 3.5 hours a week or more dealing with spam, which, by the way, is 15 years old this month. Now here to help us get the spam out of here is the web life editor for Yahoo, Heather Cabot. Good to see you, Heather.
Thank you. Welcome nice to be show. Here.
So spam is not only annoying, it's potentially harmful to us, right?
It really is. And last year, consumers lost $239 million in online fraud. I mean, it's significant. And the way that a lot of these criminals get to us is through spam, through our email. So we really need to be careful about it and take some initiative to make sure that we get it out of our inboxes.
I think spam has killed one of my computers before.
Because with viruses. Yeah,
the virus certainly affected it, and they couldn't save it. So is there a way to, you know, like the red flag, knowing that this is spam for sure?
Yeah, a couple things. Number one, if you are a user of Yahoo Mail, we have something called Spam Guard.
Yeah.
And what you should do is if you get an email, before you even open it, if the subject line looks suspicious or it's from somebody you don't know, hit the spam button on your toolbar, and that will immediately put it into spam, and it will also tell our system that you think it's junk, because that's part of it too, is that, you know, what I might think of as junk mail might not be what you think of as junk mail. And so it's really important that you take the initiative to do that. Don't just delete it, but actually mark it as spam.
Well, a lot of online emails have that now. You can like block junk, filter it out. I mean, do you guys really go and look at it, or what happens to it once you say spam it?
Well, the system actually picks up on those keywords. Mm-hmm. So it knows, okay, you know, you don't want to get this word or that word or this image, or, you know, you don't want email from this particular sender.
Right,
got it.
Okay. But some of the spam is so tricky because it'll copy, almost duplicate the name and the logo of legitimate companies.
Yeah.
You know, like Bank of America, and it'll say, you know, your account has expired, you have to re-enter your information.
Big red flag.
If
it is asking for you to enter any personal information, a password, a PIN number, an account number, pass on that one and call the, you know, if it's, for example, your bank, call your bank or go to the official website of your bank. Don't click on the link in the email, because that's another way that these con artists try to get your information.
Sure.
Well, sucker, I've fallen for that, too.
I think
gosh, what's wrong with me?
It's
enticing, and these people are smart. They're really clever, and they want your money and your information.
Bad people can sometimes be smart.
Yes.
So what's the best way to protect ourselves when we're shopping online?
Well, one thing that you can do, also if you are a Yahoo Mail subscriber, Yahoo Plus subscriber, we have something called the Dress Guard. I think this is such a great idea. Actually, even if you're not with Yahoo, you could do this. But you can create a disposable email address that you use just for shopping or travel sites or any site where you don't want to give out your personal email address. I mean, what we like to say is think of your email address as your, you know, your home phone number.
Right.
You're not just going to give it out to anybody. You want to be a little bit discerning about who you're giving it out to. And I also would add to that, that when you're signing up for, say, a newsletter, or even when you're shopping, is to make sure that you're familiar with the privacy policy of the company you're doing business with. Because a lot of these companies, if you read the fine print, they'll say that, you know, they may sell their list of addresses.
Right, right.
And, you know, you need to make sure that you know that, because that can be another way you get spammed.
I think you touched on something that was one of your takeaway tips, and that is protect your email address. And how do we go about doing that?
Well, you can create a disposable email address for yourself, just for shopping, you know, an alternate address for yourself that you use just for those sites.
Just for that, right.
Yeah, and also to just be really discerning with who you're giving it out to. Make sure you know who you're giving it out to, that, you know, it's a company that you're familiar with, and be familiar with their privacy policy.
Say no to junk mail.
Say no to junk mail. Take that initiative. Click the spam button. Don't just delete it.
Okay.
And so you said you haven't won the lottery, so be on the lookout for those things.
I mean, that's another one, too. It, you know, these people prey on, you know, everybody wants to get rich quick, right? I mean, who doesn't? And we just, all of us, and I know it sounds really simple, but we just need to remind ourselves that if it sounds too good, it probably is. And that goes for investment schemes, which are very common online. Oh, these emails about work at home, you know, get rich working at home, you know, also miracle cures, weight loss.
Right.
Don't fall for those. Yeah, and don't click those pop-up warnings.
Do not click those pop-up warnings. You know, again, that is another way that you can get reeled into some of those traps. So be careful. And if you're on a Windows computer, you just hit Control W and you can close it, or Mac Command W and you can just close it.
Heather Cabot, thank you so much.
You're
all
welcome.
Heather's tips are on our website, and you can go right to viewfromthebay.com and protect yourself online.
Yeah.
Thank
Especially
you so
if
much.
You get
you're
something welcome. From somebody you don't know, just delete it. Don't even open it up.
You got
That's it.
It.
Heather Cabot, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Your financial success is not about the money.
Hmm.
Huh. Find out why. That's coming up.